jeans zip fly, a technique to use with my jeans sewing patterns, which you can download from angelacane.com. The selvedge jeans pattern comes in 10 sizes. I've marked this calico version with an X for the wrong side. On the right side, I've labelled R and L for the right and left front pieces. The dot should be marked with a tailor's tack. This pattern requires a 4-inch, 5-inch or 6-inch zip, depending on the sewing pattern size. The metal end of the zip must be well clear of the dot. Here, the 6-inch is just a little too long, so I shall use the 5-inch. Starting with the left front, cut off the fly extension, leaving a seam allowance. Sew the separate fly extension to left front, right sides together. Press the seam towards the extension. You may think that that rather defeats the object of cutting off the extension in the first place. This is done to give a firm finish to the centre front edge. Firstly, we machine the zip to the right front. The zip is placed face down. I want the zip teeth to end up about 1/2 inch from the centre front, like so. I have the centre front line marked with a notch at the waist seam and the dot at the end of the opening. Rule a chalk line 5/8 of an inch or less away from the centre front towards the fly extension. This is the position for the right zip tape edge. At the machine, lay the zip face down with the right hand tape along the chalked line. Machine along the edge of the tape. Stop to slide the zip pull past the needle. Change to a zipper foot with the needle moved to the left. Then stitch another row close to the teeth. As you can see, when folded back, there is about 1/2 inch gap between the zip and the centre front. Place the two fronts, right sides together, zip facing up. The right front extension is folded back. You will find the zip falls into place. Check the fronts are lined up at the notches and seams. Use a couple of pins to keep the zip in place. It's easier to machine this side of the zip from the bottom up. Stitch the zip tape firstly near the tape edge and a second row close to the teeth, as before. Open the zip to do the top. With both extensions folded out, Complete the front seam beneath the zip, from the dot to the crotch. Clip to the dot on the left front only. You can then zigzag or overlock from the crotch all the way up the right front extension to neaten. This is how it looks so far from the wrong side. The zip guard will be placed centrally behind the zip. The next job is to top stitch along the centre front fold on the left front. I can do this with the zip closed and everything pushed out of the way. You don't have to start the stitching at the bottom of the opening. It will connect with stitching at a later stage. Next, I will mark a top stitching line with chalk. I like to use my pattern cutting set square, but any guide will do. Use a marker pen or pencil if you prefer. Chalk a top stitching line 1.5 inches from the center front, finishing with a nice curve towards the dot. Top stitch from the top to the dot. Hold the fabric firmly as you sew around the curve. If you want a double row, make a few stitches up the centre front fold and return to the top, keeping the spacing even. Fold the fly guard right sides together and stitch the lower end. Mitre the corner, trim, turn right side out and press. The fold is on this side and this is the finished edge. The guard goes behind the zip and it forms the underlap when the waistband is attached. You can shape the lower edge of the zip guard if you prefer, but it's not on show. Place the guard centrally over the extensions. Pin and stitch along here. Trim away this extra fabric and zigzag or overlock. For a couture finish, you often find this edge is bound in a contrast fabric with matching pocket bags and perhaps a waistband lining. So machine this edge with everything else folded out to the left. Trim and neaten. With the zip guard in place, we will be securing it in a few other ways. Firstly, stitching it down here from the front. Make sure the zip guard is lying flat. Open the zip and stitch down the right front center fold. Again, stop when you get to the pull tab and slide it past the needle. Just stitch as far as you can. Snip the seam below the zip. You may not need to do this in practice, as denim behaves differently. It helps to keep the seam flat for the top stitching. From the crotch, top stitch close to the seam on the left front, up to and just beyond the previous stitching on the center front fold. Take a few stitches across and then back to the end of the seam, giving you a nice double top stitch. Machine a bar tack or two, which secures the fly guard in place. You can do these bar tacks in all sorts of ways. Just create a look you like. The bar tacks keep the zip guard in place. They're not just for decoration. Next, I will be sewing the one-piece pocket bag. Sewing patterns can be downloaded from angelacane.com. I have the easiest format for PDF patterns. You don't have to be a member. You can shop for individual patterns, videos, and eBooks. Members get everything included. It's excellent value. Tweet questions at angelacane.com or leave a comment below. To keep up to date with the latest videos, please subscribe to this channel, and a like will do wonders for my YouTube ratings. Thank you very much for watching this video.